Good morning, students. I hope you are safe at home. Due to complete lockdown in India, schools are off, but still we can learn at home. Our SGTP team is providing you some online video lectures, so you better understand it. Today lecture is for class plus 2 science. The today topic is colligative property. It comes from chapter solution. Colligative property is the most important topic of the chapter, because every year in board exam, one numerical is from this topic. So first we will discuss colligative properties. The properties which are dependent on the number of moles of molecules or ions of solute particles, irrespective of nature of solute particles. There are only four colligative properties. First is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Second is elevation in boiling point. Third is depression in freezing point. Fourth is osmotic pressure. Every year from these four properties, one numerical is there. So first we will discuss relative lowering of vapor pressure. Now take a look. If we take a volatile solvent A and we add non-volatile solute B, then total vapor pressure of solution will be PS equal to PA plus PB. PS represents vapor pressure of solution, PA represents vapor pressure of a solvent, PB represents vapor pressure of a solute. But this solute is non-volatile. If this is non-volatile, so definitely it will not evaporate, then vapor pressure will be 0. So we can say PB equal to 0. If we put the value 0, then final vapor pressure of solution will be PS equal to PA. Is clear? Okay. But as we discussed Raoult's law, PA equal to P naught A XA. PA vapor pressure of pure solvent, vapor pressure of solvent, P naught A vapor pressure of pure solvent, XA is the mole fraction of solvent. So we can use this instead of PA. Then PS will be P naught A XA. This equation can be written as PS by P naught A equal to XA. As we have discussed, mole fraction of solution is always 1. XA plus XB equal to 1. So we can rewrite XA equal to 1 minus XB. We can use this instead of XA. PS by P naught A equal to 1 minus XB. Now further we can use some further equations. PS by P naught A minus 1 equal to XB. Rewrite it, 1 minus PS by P naught A equal to XB. We can take LCM, P naught A minus PS by P naught A equal to XB. This is our first equation. What this equation represents? Now understand it. Here P naught A minus PS. P naught A is the vapor pressure of pure solvent and PS is the vapor pressure of solution. So it indicates that vapor pressure has been reduced. So we can say this is the lowering of vapor pressure. But this lowering has been observed with respect to pure solvent. So this complete P naught A minus PS by P naught A is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Is clear? Now we can expand this equation further. Okay? We have concluded P naught A minus PS by P naught A equal to XB. This was our first equation. But as we know, mole fraction of solute is the number of moles of solute by total number of moles of a solution. So I can use xB equal to nB by nA plus nB. It's easy. So we can put here P naught A minus PS by P naught A equal to nB by nA plus nB. Easy. Now further we can expand for a dilute solution. For a dilute solution, when concentration of solute is less than of 5%. In that case we can say nA is much greater than nB. If nA is much greater than nB, then definitely nA plus nB is almost equivalent to nA. nA plus nB is almost equivalent to nA. We can use it here. So our equation will be modified to P naught A minus PS by P naught A equal to nB by nA. This is the second equation. And hence we can say this relative lowering of vapor pressure is dependent on moles of solute, as we have discussed in the definition. This property can be even used to find out the molecular weight of unknown solute. What we have to do, we will just use the basic formula of number of moles. So this equation I will use in this way. P naught A minus PS by P naught A equal to nB can be written as WB by nB. nA can be written as WA by nA, yani nA upar aayega by WA. This is third equation. Easy. If we have relative lowering of vapor pressure and nature of solute is unknown, so we can find out the molecular weight. Easy. So if we have to find out molecular weight, then I will write it here. P naught A minus PS by P naught A. I can use it as delta P. Delta P represents the relative lowering of vapor pressure. Is it? So this complete relative lowering can be written as delta P. Now further, due to lack of some space, I will use this delta P here. Delta P equal to WB by NB into MA by WA. Clear? If we have to find out the molecular weight, then the equation will be molecular weight equal to WB by delta B into MA by WA. So colligative properties can be used to find out the molecular weight of unknown solute. Is it? Okay. So this numerical, first numerical can be from the this property, relative lowering of vapor pressure. Numerical portion, I will give you some numericals in PDF. So please solve the PDF and send it to me back. I will cross check it and will send you also back. You see, the remaining three properties we will discuss in the next lecture. Okay. So this is for today. I think you will understand it at home. You may call me anytime and may message me anytime. So stay at home, keep learning. Thank you.